Hey, what's up, guys? Eric Gonzalez here from Produce Like a Pro, also Warren's engineer and studio manager here at Spitfire Studios. I'm here to introduce today's video, which is of three different excerpts from three different mixing courses by three different producers. So in these excerpts, we're going to follow these three different producers and their master bus processing. So let's get started. Here first, we have Mark Needham, whose credits feature Fleetwood Mac, The Killers, Imagine Dragons, Pink, and many more. So although Mark's master bus processing varies from each project, for mixing this track by Jay Clifford, Mark hits different compressors lightly rather than hitting one hard. He uses the same trick with hitting multiple EQ plugins lightly, with the goal of keeping the aggression on the top end as it was, but adding warmth to the bottom. Let's check it out.
I run several things in my stereo bus chain. I'll kind of show you what they are. This kind of varies from project to project how much I'm using of what, but I'll turn all these on and sort of show what I'm doing on this song. A combination of a couple different compressors, between an SSL G and the Shadow Hills. So those are kind of the main compression that I'm using on this song. So let's look at the loud section here. So on this song, I'm using most. I'll use, you know, I'll go down to like a dB or so with the optical side, which is kind of just a soft, pretty transparent compression. You're not really hearing a lot of pump or anything from that. And then I'm going to pick up with a super fast release, like another dB of compression with the SSL here. So I'm going to, you know, maybe another couple dB of compression with that. And then I have a few different EQs that I'm using, but I'm also doing let's go to this first. I'm using an ATR or analog simulator on the mix, transformer off. I don't like the way the transformer on just kind of sucks away too much of the bottom, but I'm using that on a 15 IPS setting. Just kind of, I had a lot of ATRs when I was doing analog. We used to have four of those, and I just love the bottom end at 15 IPS on these things. So it's kind of emulating that bottom end that the ATRs have. I can turn it in and out for you. There's on. There's out. At the 15 IPS, and you can hear that little bump in the bottom in there. It's kind of fattens the kick drum and the bass up. So. I'm using a combination of a few EQs. I'm using this Meg EQ, which I use to just lift a little bit overall in the sub range. There's out. I'm using two of the Chandler curve benders as well. I've used one that I'm just pushing another dB at 70 overall on the mix, and a little 12K. And then the second one, I'm just pushing like just a little sub down at 35. I'll turn both those off for a minute. My concept here is I'm going to try to keep this song super aggressive on the top end like the other mix was, but hopefully have it just a lot warmer and fatter on the bottom, but still keep that same super aggression on the vocal and the guitar. Oh, one other thing I'm hitting also is I'm using this slate compressor or slate limiter. So we're just have that set so we're not peeking out on the loudest part. And I love this, the low punch and the detail on the transients on this thing, on this unit. It's subtle, but I just think it really gives a little more definition on the low end and the cymbals and snare.
All right, switching genres. Right here, we're going to go to mixing hip-hop with Ariel Chobaz. Ariel's credits feature Nicki Minaj, Drake, Justin Bieber, DJ Khaled, and many more. So here we follow Ariel master a hip-hop track. He tries to get as much compression as he can without distorting or having it be audible. Ariel also explains his use of adaptive compression, squashing the bottom end, but relaxing on the top end with a multiband compressor. Let's check it out.
So the most simple thing, the L2, right? Everyone use it. I'm sure you use it. I love it. What can I say? I'm just going to try to get as much compression as I can without distorting it or without making it too audible that I'm squishing it. So we can turn it down.
Yeah, I've been up all night trying to make a change. Since I've been on the upside, they've been acting strange.
You can see I'm already clipping zero.
Coffee by the liter, I'm just trying to stay awake.
So when I unbypass this, it's already compressing like a dB and I haven't even brought the threshold.
Don't try to hit me with the shame.
Putting a couple like 0.2 dB of headroom. Just so it doesn't actually hit red, and that way if you have any software that's looking for that digital zero, you're not quite clipping it, so it won't automatically turn it down. Plus I like having that tiny bit of headroom.
Yeah, I've been up all night trying to make a change. Since I've been on the upside, they've been acting strange. I barely seen the outside, writing through the day. Coffee by the liter, I'm just trying to stay awake. My bitch and you're not mistreat her. Cause all I'm hearing is my speaker. Don't try to hit me with the shame. You know I'm married to the game. You know I'm married to the game.
Right away, I can kind of hear that the kick and the bass, it might be a little overpowering on the song right now. It's kind of hitting the compressor kind of hard, but we'll check it all out. I'm going to go ahead and bring up at this point a multiband compressor. There's plenty. I'm going to bring up this linear multiband. It's been around a while. Everyone should have it if you have any of the Waves plugins. And I want to show you this cool one, this adaptive multi-electro mastering. Now, what's cool about this one is it has a certain amount of adaptive quality. And what I mean is, basically, when the compressor hits, it can start to sound squashed, especially when the low end hits really hard. Now, what the adaptive compression does is when the low end hits really hard, it relaxes the compression on the top end. So it's going to squash or compress the bottom and relax the compression on the top. So that way it doesn't sound like it's really squashing the track down. I think it's pretty cool, especially if you have really bass heavy stuff. You can get that compression and it won't give you that pumping, aggressive, compressive sound because every time that bass is getting compressed, it's automatically releasing, or I should say relaxing, the compression on the upper bands. So it's kind of cool.
Yeah, I've been up all night trying to make a change. Since I've been on the upside, they've been acting strange. I barely seen the outside, writing through the day. Coffee by the liter, I'm just trying to stay awake. My bitch and you're not mistreat her. Cause all I'm hearing is my speaker.
Now, after this multiband compression, I am reducing the level. You probably saw me normalize the gain here. That's because after all, you know, my years of working with this plugin, I've found this gain stage distorts easier than if I just use an L2. So you saw it was boosting about 2.4 dB. I'm just gonna do the same thing with the L2. So that way I'm not doing it on individual bands that are then getting summed. I'm taking everything that's summed and then pushing it again another 2.4. And again, making that ceiling just right there a little bit. Now, the other thing I should mention is I'm definitely not a professional mastering engineer, and I'm sure, you know, most of you guys aren't either. There is kind of this debate about how much mastering we should be doing as mixers, but I say it's quality control. You want your stuff, when you're sending out your mixes, they're going to be compared to everything else that everyone's listening to, which is mastered. So I never claim to be a mastering engineer, but I do inform my clients that I send out my mixes with my own mastering on it, strictly as quality control, because most people, when they play stuff back, whatever's louder sounds better. That's just kind of how we're designed and how we're built. So we got to kind of take that into consideration.
And last but not least, we have the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Warren Hewitt, mixing pop rock. His credits are The Fray, Aerosmith, Rick Springfield, Ace Frehley, and lots more. So in this course, Warren is mixing using only Waves plugins. For the master bus processing, he is emulating what he actually does with his 2-bus off of his SSL console, the one behind me. For this, he's using the Waves SSL channel and the SSL compressor. Then afterwards, he hits it with the Waves L2 for loudness and a little more limiting. Let's check it out.
What could we do that's really, really tasty on compression? So I'm going to bring in my favorites. SSL EQ. As you can see, there's this thing called an SSL over here. I'm then going to grab the SSL bus compressor, because why wouldn't you? I use one every day. The compressor, and then lastly, an L2. So let's go to the EQ first. I turn off the SSL comp and the L2, so we're just hearing this. To fix my half a heart and stitch me up inside before I rip apart. I wonder where I'd be if I had you from the start. I really need someone. All that left was half a heart. Will I make it? So I've got a couple of dB at 12k and like 8, just under a dB at 60. Probably all I need to do, but it's nice just to have it there. Okay, so I'm gonna put the threshold to the full right, the gain makeup on 0. Let's see what we got. On my SSL, I tend to go at either 2 or 4 to 1, and I go onto auto for the release. Just tucking it in, it's really, really nice, obviously, on the snare. It's a big, big deal. Okay, here's the L2. To fix my half a heart and stitch me up inside before I rip apart. I wonder where I'd be if I want to fix my half a heart and stitch me up inside. I'm superstitious. I always put it on 0.1, so it's never at 0 dB. I mean, that's just working wonders. The L2 is a secret weapon of pretty much everybody. The hardware version of the L2 is in pretty much every single mastering studio around the world that I've ever been to. To fix my half a heart and stitch me up inside before I rip apart. I wonder where I'd be if I had you from the start. I really need someone.
my beauty to the floor. I can move, can't change a thing. I bend, I break, just know you played a part. Can't change a thing. I bend, I break, just know you played a part. You know who you are.
Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Again, I'm Eric Gonzalez from Produce Like a Pro. If you want to check out more of these courses, you can head over to promixacademy.com. Don't forget, smash that like button, subscribe, and I'll see you again in the next one.